very close. And so Lendl has held serves, even the count. One all, final set.
To start a new service game, he shows you something else. He'd gone all the way up to about 60% in the second set, then started his first service game of this set was 30. And now we just see him pull off a cold winner out of nowhere. Very erratic stuff when Yvonne serves. Nicely constructed point. John did a good job of moving Yvonne all over the court. Sets himself up for the biggie.
John quite happy that ball was a fault. As Lendl almost broken.
What is the whistling about? I don't understand. What's the whistling about?
How is the whistling
about this time?
The whistling, John, is because they thought it was a good serve. And they're criticizing the lines person, I suspect. But John has a point. I don't know why they whistle, except they're mad at the call.
I think they were whistling from the point before. They thought Lendl hit a big, bold winner, not realizing that John serve was out.
And there is a great forehand topspin lob. Lendl so confident.
John is thinking, oh, I had my fill of that shot at the U.S. Open. Yvonne was throwing him over John's head all over the U.S. Open quarterfinals.
Steps right into it. McEnroe tries to hook him, but the ball didn't carry very far, and Lendl's waiting for it in the alley. Has the backhand grip. Uses that left arm to get the right in position. On the dead run, McEnroe hits the little volley, and Lendl with the bolo punch forehand knocks it by him.
Another terrific sprint by Yvonne Lendl to stay in this point, and then a big swipe with the forehand to end it. That really was a dramatic charge to stay in this game.
Lendl's one of the few guys in the game when he runs with the racket in position and then doesn't have to take it back upon the hit.
Strong running by Yvonne Lendl, finally force the error from McEnroe. who might have been able to end that shot with a better stab at the backhand. But Yvonne was still in the point.
And now a 3-all, Lendl with a very important break point. McEnroe serves right at his right hip. Lendl turns but can't handle it. Beautiful serving. Ace for the lefty. Oh. And McEnroe with the slice serve wide manages to hold and move ahead 4-3 in the final.
The 1987.
McEnroe must maintain that first serving consistency, keep the pressure on Lendl.
Be a broken string. Yep. Right at the top of the frame.
You know, Mary, we mentioned about Lendl and McEnroe dominating the U.S. Open for the past 7 years. They've also won the Nabisco Masters year-end final in the Garden. The last 6 consecutive years between them.
Lendl favored to win that again this year. John McEnroe won't even be there. His suspension has kept him from trying to improve his 10th place position right now. Second serve. Boy, how tough is it to come up with a second serve after all that time?
Love 15. And Lendl lets this opportunity slip by.
Seem to react well to that.
John under pressure here, 4-all in the final set, and he knows it.
15-30 here. Got him.
He handled that volley awfully well, right at his stomach. Never flinched, never faltered. He's got the backhand grip as he makes this volley right off his stomach. John chiding himself. Just missed. Second ball. Oh. And now Lendl sticks his head out. He's got the break point here. Look at the backhand. Leans into it. That's his favorite shot when he's got time.
Second break point. This could give Yvonne a chance to serve out the match.
And that is a magnificent first serve. He crosses him up, goes down the center. It's a tough serve for a left-hander in the deuce in the Ed court.
Just where it landed.
And we're going into Russian roulette, the 13-point tiebreak. First player to win seven by a margin of two wins the match.
Last time these two played a 12-point tiebreak, it was McEnroe who won it. That